Hey, welcome back. We're the
Three Musketeers!
And we just finished tour and we had lots of great memories.
In this video, we're revisiting all the ups and downs we had this tour.
And watch to the end because I almost overslept for a show.
When?
I'll show you guys, okay?
Alright, let's go! What's something you're going to miss about tour?
The food.
Vegetables.
The catering team that prepares the food for Shen Yun on tour is really good.
Usually it's like so many dishes, like a variety of cuisine, so they eat a lot more vegetables on tour.
Audience, like audience reaction, their clapping and their laugh and everything.
Traveling and trying food from all over the world.
Immerse myself in different ways, like in different places.
Going out, exploring new places.
For example, in Seattle, go there, I really recommend you try the clam chowder at Pike Place Market.
Good.
What's one thing you're not going to miss about tour? Being away from family? Come on in. Yeah! Everybody's here now.
Hi.
Yay! Okay, bye.
Long bus ride. Really, really tiring.
Two things I'm not gonna miss about tour is definitely one, wearing heels like all the time, and two, wearing super heavy makeup. So when I'm back on campus, I can actually take this time to actually just like let my skin breathe for a bit and revive it.
You have to travel on one luggage only. It really feels like I'm constricted. The minimalist thing does not work for me, okay? When I'm back at home, I have everything I need, my teapots, and it feels so good. So I do not survive well on minimalism and one luggage. What are you doing? You need to be on stage right now. The show started. No, we don't have time. Just throw them on.
What?
No, just try it. Just literally throw them on. Costume, put on your costume. Come on, man, you gotta hurry up! Are you sleepy again? You gotta hurry up! They're on the second half already!
What?
It's only been 30 seconds, though! Hey, your company manager is looking for you.
Hey, he's over here. I found him.
No, he's just been sleeping the whole time.
What?
Wait, no. Hey, no. No.
Hey.
Hey, you're here. I'm going on stage like this. Where are you going? The season's over. Whatever, it's my vacation now. What are you going to focus on now after tour?
My graduate school and choreography.
This is an easy one. It's definitely going to be teaching. And we have a dance assessment coming up very, very soon.
We have to show how much we improve this half year.
A lot of more like practicing, because on tour we actually don't get that much time to do things like our routines and stuff.
There's mirrors, there's bars, so I can actually focus on things that I'm not sure where I am at.
I can just like slow down and actually heal my feet for a bit, and also just focus on just the basics.
We finished the tour, but it's pretty busy. I know that there's at least around 10 things that I need to make.
Okay, I don't know what they're doing. What is the most important lesson you learned this tour? mind over matter.
Being able to adjust your attitude in any situation you come across. You can't really choose what you're faced with, but you can decide how to deal with it and how to go about it.
In Mexico, we were struggling a little bit, but seeing 5,000 audience members in Mexico City for one show, that was amazing, okay? And I was instantly pumped up.
Cherish every single performance, because before this tour, we actually had a stretch of time that we didn't get to tour because of the pandemic.
Through wind and through rain, through trouble and pain.
Coming back to tour and touring this year, it makes me view touring like in a whole different perspective. And every single show that I do, I cherish now. And I need to remember this feeling. So in the future, after like 20, no, not 20. Maybe I'll be touring after 20 years. After like, you know, 3-4 years, I'll still be remembering this feeling I had and cherish every single show. Dang it, I'm going on stage like this. Oh, forget it, I'm going on stage like...
You're creating a mess, dude. What are you doing?
I'm sorry, dude.
Okay, so if we were going back in time, what is something you would have done differently?
Practice more, even though I feel really tired, and just try to improve after 16 years.
I would have swam more, eating less of those yeast rolls from Golden Corral. They really mean it when it's instant rice. I had to work extra. When I was younger, I was in a swim team. On tour, there's like a lot of pools at the hotels, and then I get a bit lazy sometimes because, you know, our schedule is so tight and then my body's kind of tired, but then I regret not swimming enough because it's actually pretty good instead of, you know, because we dance all the time, but then swimming is also a good way to just move your body in a different way and also exercise.
I can be more diligent and I can be more nice and...
Nice to who?
Nice to everyone. I mean, I'm not saying that bad, you know, but I'm saying it can be never enough to be nice to other people.
Nothing I would really do differently. It was a great tour.
I think it's one of the best tours I've ever had. Everybody worked together well. We had successful shows. The audience feedback was good. It's one of my best tours. So I gotta say, I have actually no major regrets this tour. This is behind the scenes, this is how we make sure that his leg is in the same place every single time for this, okay? So, don't tell anybody, okay? Are there any memorable experiences you had with members in your company this tour?
Supporting each other through tough times and really tiring schedules during tour.
In Philadelphia, it was actually this year's tour, was my second time spending my birthday there. And the members of my company, they surprised me with a cake and they sang happy birthday to me. And I was like super excited. And then right after, the orchestra actually sang it again, because in our orchestra, there was also another member in our troupe that had the exact same birthday as me.
Are there any bad memories or some struggles?
I had a bad experience with somebody, but it is a good thing. Let me explain. So I had a bad experience with my friend Jisung, my best friend Jisung, because as you guys might have known, we're making a short film on tour. So we're having shows and we're filming. So it was a very stressful situation. We had our little argument, but afterwards we kind of made up. And I think that bad experience was actually a good thing because we got to learn from each other. We got to understand each other better. And do I like Jisung as a person now? Of course I do.
Liar!
Oh, Jisung is here, by the way.
Liar.
He's going next.
What do you want to say to the audience members that have watched the show this year?
Thank you. From very deep in my heart, I want to say thank you. You guys are actually what gave me the inspiration to continue and do better and improve. After our performances, we kind of watch the audience feedbacks, and sometimes like the feedback is so like profound, it's so touching that like it inspires me so much.
This means a lot when the audience members are able to take away something really valuable and precious that they can apply to their daily lives. And when we hear the audience reviews and feedbacks, we just feel like everything that we've worked for and dedicated for is really worth it.
We just really want to like...
Thank you very much for coming, and we'll see you guys next year. Yay!
Is it recording?
Yeah, it is. I don't know if... I'm eating snacks right now. I'm like Jisung.